Good afternoon, everyone. I am Divyanshi Singh, an officer trainee of Indian Revenue Service. On the behalf of Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration, I welcome one and all present here for this special gathering. At our academy today, we are honored to host Shri Suhas L. Yathiraj, Indian Administrative Service Officer of 2007 batch. We also have with us Honorable Director Sir, We also have with us Honorable Director Sir, Srinivas R. Kathikithala, Honorable Joint Director Ma'am, Radhika Rastogi, and the respected faculty members, I welcome you all. Our premises today are blessed with the presence of a dignitary who has unfurled the tricolor at a global stage in the most awaited sports meet. Suhas sir has bagged silver medal in the game of badminton in 2020 Paralympics. In 2020 Paralympics at Tokyo. Congratulations, sir. Suhas sir, an IS officer of 2007 batch belonging to Uttar Pradesh cadre, is an Arjuna awardee. He happens to be the first civil servant to get this award. He is also recipient of more than 20 medals in different international badminton competitions, including 6 gold medals. Sir has served as district magistrate in Maharajganj, Hathras, Sonbhadra, Jaunpur, Ajamgarh, Prayagraj, and Gautam Buddha Nagar presently. He was awarded Yash Bharti, the highest civilian honor of Uttar Pradesh in 2016. His COVID management efforts were appreciated not only by the state government, but also by the central government. As a DM of Prayagraj, he successfully conducted Kumbh Mela in 2019. The election management efforts that he spearheaded in 2015 were awarded by Honorable Governor of Uttar Pradesh. We welcome you, sir. It is just our second week in the academy, and we have already got a glimpse of generosity of our director, sir. His feats in fitness are no doubt the talks of academy. I welcome sir on behalf of all the officer trainees. Our joint director madam, Ms. Radhika Rastogi, an IS officer of Maharashtra cadre, is known for her virtuous conduct and immense wisdom. She has served in different capacities since 1995 and has given justice to all her roles. We welcome you, ma'am.
I request everybody to join us in the Academy song.
रहो धर्म च धीर रहो चवीर रखो उच्चा सिर डरो ना। होआ धर्म तीर होआ कर्म तीर रख उन्नत वीर भय नाय। हो उन्नत शीर नहीं भय हो उन्नत शीर नहीं भय।
I welcome on stage Director Sir Sri Srinivas R. Kathiktala Sir to present to our chief guest with a token of appreciation.
Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration is proud to recognize the achievements of its alumnus Suhas L. Yathiraj Sir, an officer of the 2007 batch of the Administrative Service Uttar Pradesh Cadre. Shri Yathiraj Sir is the first civil servant to receive the nation's highest honor in sports, the Arjuna Award, in 2021. He is best known for his silver medal victory in badminton at the Paralympic Games in Tokyo in 2020. And once again creating history by becoming the first Indian civil servant to be distinguished with this honor. The evolving mural of his victories is a product of the deep-set virtues of hard work and uncompromising dedication. Shri Yathiraj's life is a testimony to the idea that an officer of the Indian Administrative Service must be a specialist of the context. He strived to gaining greater and greater knowledge and proficiency in all fields which he got exposed to. His life inspires his peers to strive, overcome, and achieve high. The Academy is further delighted to note that Shri Suhas L. Yathiraj Sir learned the game of badminton at the Academy during his training period.
I request Director Shri Srinivas R. Kathiktala Sir to kindly share his thoughts.
It's a great pleasure to welcome Suhas back to the alma mater. The Academy is always a home to all of us, no matter where we are, and we take great privilege in welcoming back one of us back home. So welcome back home. There is a special pride in our welcome today, a warmth that competes with the brightest sun of Mussoorie's blue winter skies. And this is because in Suhas, we have an achiever, a member of our services, who has worked tirelessly over the years to hone his skills in a sport that he has picked up here in Shalwell campus. He apparently learned from his coach who challenged him in the badminton courts in Happy Valley, and now has demonstrated to the world what fortitude and will can be and what it can result in. He represents to all of us the highest achievements of our peers and colleagues. As I was watching him and as I was thinking, my mind went to many of our colleagues who have excelled similarly. One name that comes to my mind is of an 82 batch officer, Mr. Paparao. Some of you who will go to Assam Northeast will remember him as Home Commissioner, but he learned at that time. He joined the service pretty late. I think he joined at the age of 28 and learned to ride at the academy, 82 batch, participated in the Asiad as a part of the Indian contingent, won silver medals, and he, in his life thereafter, demonstrated tremendous courage. Everybody knows him to be very, very courageous, very brave, and an officer who actually led from the front. In Suhas, we have a similar example. Just about half an hour back, or in the last half an hour, we heard Captain B.K. Sinha speak to us. I did tell you that Mr. B.K. Sinha also demonstrated similar courage. You must know that he, of course, is a senior from my cadre. And as Municipal Commissioner Ahmedabad, while he faced bullets in Bangladesh, he was attacked in his own office by several very, very agitated crowds. And it literally almost lost his life there. People came with chairs and all that. There was a total affray there. But he showed tremendous courage, tremendous spirit, and he held on. The point I'm trying to make here is that in the academy, through our outdoor activities, through our sporting activities, through our exposure to the field of competitive sport, this is the spirit we try to nurture every time so that you're always courageous, you're always bold, you always lead the team from the front. We have heard Suhas's achievements, many achievements. We are so proud. And lastly, during the COVID, you will know many of you is almost a social media sensation for his work as District Magistrate Greater Noida, for his responsiveness, for his utter empathy, and the kind of yeoman service that he rendered in the district. And I'm sure that all of you will find similar inspiration from his life, from the life of Captain B.K. Sinha, and all others that we come in contact with. We know that he has been a great success in the sporting arena. He has succeeded in the Asian Para Badminton Championship, of course, the Tokyo Paralympics, number of national and international competitions. We tend to think of achievers as a class apart. We tend to think, no, they're different, they're made different. There must be something in them which is not in us and tend to hold ourselves back. I think examples like Suhas, who is here to exchange his and then share where his experience with us, tell us that all of us here, young people, have in us the ability to reach and scale the highest. It is only our own mind, it is our own will, and it is our own imagination that will limit you to the extent to which you can rise and achieve. Suhas, who has gained enormous renown in this field of badminton, has gained renown in the field of administration, and we find that by interacting with him as a part of our program of the sportsperson in residence, and he's the first who's joining us, we will be able to exchange those small facets. What is it that at that tipping point, when there were perhaps moments of doubt, where there were perhaps those moments when you felt, how do I overcome that little bit of inhibition? I think it is an opportunity for all of us to interact and learn from Suhas. Our understanding of this kind of a spirit will also get strengthened and reinforced by examples such as Suhas, who is here with us. Suhas's life also, I think, exemplifies the Olympic motto, citius, highest, fastest, strongest, fastest, altius, highest, fortius, strongest. I think he has been inspired by this call He represents this, the spirit of this, and we are tremendously proud to have him here. And as a true embodiment that of the best that all of us aspire to be, and the best that this academy aspires to create, and we are truly proud to have you back, Suhas. Congratulations, and best wishes, and welcome back.
Thank you so much. Please join hands in giving a warm welcome to Sri Suhas L. Yathiraj, sir, in sharing his outstanding achievement about the recent past and also about his experiences in balancing being a civil servant with sports.
You can hear me? Yes. Dear director, sir, it's indeed a pleasure meeting you. I had always heard so many great things about you when you were in Government of India and in academy. In the short period, the work that you have done, it's an honor for me to meet you, sir. Give a big round of applause for director, sir. The officer trainees are extremely lucky to get an officer like Srinivas, sir, as their director. And congratulations to you also, all the dear faculty members who look as young as the officer trainees are. I have met many of you. So round of applause to them also. And my dear officer trainees, this will be, with the permission of director, sir, this will be a completely informal session. Because I was told, in our times, the biggest challenge for a speaker in Sampurna Anand is not to ensure that officer trainees don't go into the Sampurna Anand. So my request to Monica ma'am would be, if any officer trainee dozes off, then the memo should come to me, because there is something wrong in me. So with that, very few words from my side, then we'll interact. We'll open the floor. The title is Life, Glory, and Destiny. This is what encapsulates what I'm going to talk about. Next slide. Can you play that for 45 seconds? It's a short video, YouTube video. Watch the lyrics. Listen to the song and watch the lyrics. So, we will all die one day. We should all live a life that we should remember for ourselves. That says it all, isn't it? Next slide. Gratitude. One side peeche. You have all arrived. Why? Because after 10 days of foundation course, after clearing UPSC, you must all be in cloud 9, though few OTs have told ki sir balloon to thoda burst ho gaya, but phir bhi you should be. But it's always good to have a sense of gratitude and to be grounded. Kyon? This is the beginning. Next slide. I'll talk about, at the cost of boasting about my achievements, but कुछ चीजें अपनी लाइफ के बारे में बताऊंगा. As they say, a journey of a 1,000 mile begins with a single step. आप लोग यूपीएससी क्रैक किए हैं. मैं जो भी बताऊंगा, वॉट एवर आई स्पीक, देर इज नथिंग दैट यू डोंट नो. इफ एट द एंड ऑफ माई टॉक if I can provoke a few thoughts in each one of you. You are all intellectually बहुत superior है, आप लोग UPSC crack करके लाखों लोगों में यहाँ आए हैं, तो आप already you have arrived. But few thoughts. First step लेने में हम हमेशा कोई भी नए रास्ते में सफर में डरते हैं. In 2016 there was a state level able bodied championship. I was the DM then in that district. I was supposed to inaugurate the championship. मैंने वहाँ कहा कि inaugurate तो हम कर ही लेंगे, पहले हम खेल लेते हैं. So I defeated two able bodied players of state level at that time. And मेरे कोच ने कहा कि इंडियन टीम कोच आए हुए थे, उन्होंने कहा कि आप तो इतने अच्छे खेलते हैं, आपको प्रोफेशनली खेलनी चाहिए. हमने कहा कि कलेक्ट्री करें बैठ के कि बैडमिंटन खेलें. सो इन्होंने कहा कि ये विजिटिंग कार्ड रखिए, अगर कभी आपको मन करता है तो आप मुझे फ़ोन करना. चार पाँच महीने हुआ, आप इन ऑल योर लाइफ नाउ यू आर यू नो एज आई सेड दिस आर द मोमेंट्स यू विल चेरिश इन योर लाइफ. एज यू सेटल डाउन यू विल ऑलवेज आस्क योर सेल्फ द क्वेश्चन व्हाट नेक्स्ट इन लाइफ. आई ऑल्सो आस्क माई सेल्फ द क्वेश्चन व्हाट नेक्स्ट इन लाइफ. तो आई फेल्ट कि इट इज एक देर इज ऑलवेज बीन अ फंडा इन माई लाइफ, अ प्रिंसिपल. It is okay to try and fail than to have not tried at all. Keep this in every aspect of your life. Aapne UPSC mein kiya hai. You have all done this in UPSC because you were ready for failures. That is how you actually succeeded. So I called him after 6 months. Unhone kaha der aaye durust aaye. You have called after 6 months. If you want to play in Beijing, the Asian Championship is going to be held after 3 months. You have to be quite fit and you have to prepare well. So done, landed in Beijing. First match, I was an unseeded player and I was extremely anxious how it will turn out. And I lost the first set. Second set, I was trailing. And if I had lost that match, probably I would have been out of the tournament, I would have never played badminton again. But then I told to myself ki I will earn my bread back in India, but here let me leave the fear in the chair when I was sipping the drink at the middle of the second set. Let me go out and play without any fear. Went onto the court, not only did I win the set, I went on to win the match and went on to become the first unseeded player to win the Asian Championship in Beijing. So the lesson is, what do we conquer in any competition? Your own fear. Your own fear. Next slide. Boring to nahi ho raha hai na? Theek hai. How many of you have seen the movie Pursuit of Happiness? Good. Mujhe laga ki ye to Squid Games wali batch hai, to Pursuit of Happiness bhi dekhe hai. So life is in many senses Pursuit of Happiness, isn't it? When I wanted to play in Paralympics, to get into Paralympics itself is very tough. Why? You have to, in badminton, we had to play in 12 different countries. We had to be in top 3 or 4 because there is continental quota and so many other factors involved. So I was district magistrate. I requested the state government ki mujhe I need to travel almost every month. I need some posting wherein I can actually travel every month. Many people told me ki why are you trying to, it is better to have one bird in the hand than to aim at two birds in the bush. You are already a district collector of Prayagraj, you are having good life. What is the surety that you will even qualify or you will even start doing well? So maine kaha the principle, it is okay to try and fail than to have not tried at all. Theek hai. So started the journey for qualification of Paralympics. And first tournament mein hi gold medal mila laga to ye to bahut aasan hai. Then I started losing continuously. I lost 4 quarter finals in a row. Mera my coach called me aside and told ki 2 more tournaments are remaining, Brazil and Peru. if you don't win gold in each of the tournament, you're losing quarterfinals only. If you don't win gold in these two tournaments, it is your dreams of Paralympics. It's better you go and do whatever you are, you feel you want to do. Humne kaha again, the principle. It is better to try and fail without fear. So landed in Sao Paulo, Brazil. And pre-quarterfinal, third set, harte harte jeet gaya. Quarterfinal, third set, harte harte jeet gaya. I have to win gold. Semi-final, third set. Final against world number one, 2019. Next slide. Play that video. 2019. Wait. Yes, watch this. 2019 now. Gold medal in Brazil. Gold medal in Peru. Got a ticket to Tokyo. Harte harte, ticket mil gaya. Then at Tokyo, at the elite level, everybody is fit, everybody is skilled, everybody is talented, everybody is willing to give up their life for their country. What differentiates the winners and the losers? Only one factor. How you handle pressure. You've all written UPSC. You know for a fact there are students who might have worked harder than you, who might be more intelligent than you, but who did not end up in Mussoorie. Between old Rajendra Nagar and Mussoorie, the difference is those who handled pressure. You handled pressure well in your examination duration, 3 hours, 6 hours. You performed well there, irrespective of how you prepared. So I qualified for first knockout matches, then I qualified into the semi-final. Semi-final is the medal match. So then you will go forward. In Jakarta, in Asian Games, I had lost to Freddy Setiawan. He was an Indonesian player in 2018. Straight sets in quarterfinals. And he is my opponent here in Tokyo. So one day, one night before, I could not sleep for a single hour. Not a single hour. I switched off my lights in my Olympic village at 9:30. But my mind is continuously thinking about Jakarta, where I have lost to the same person. And he is standing between me and the medal. And next day, obviously, you have not slept all night, even though you wanted to. I go there, and before entering the hall, he's an Indonesian player. He's praying to his God. I am praying to my God. So, maine dekha ki he's also equally tensed. Aadha main thoda relax hua. He's also tensed. I'm also tensed. So. I meditated for around 2 minutes. I told myself, whatever I would have done before in my life does not matter. Whatever I am going to do after this does not matter. Next 1 hour, I am willing to give up my life for this medal of Paralympics. And as the destiny has it, I defeated him in straight set and got the medal. Finals. I had almost defeated world number one. I was on the verge of winning the gold medal. First set I had won, second set it was I was 4 points away. But then I ended up losing the gold medal and winning the silver medal. Main ye sochta hu ki God would have thought if I give you gold medal now, so you will stop playing. So probably he wants me to play. Life is like that. We don't control the results. Karmanye vadhikaraste maapaleshu kadachana. But we control how we respond to what we are getting. Now I can either sit and repent on those 4 points when I didn't play well in finals, or I can get my thoughts together and think of Paris. It's okay to try and fail than to have not tried at all. Yes or no? Next slide. बोर तो नहीं हो रहे हो ना? संपूर्ण आनंद किसी को नहीं मिल रहा है ना? हाँ, क्योंकि वरना मुझे मेमो मिलने वाली है. सीरियसली, सो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव सीन द मूवी सेरेंडिपिटी? रेस्ट ऑफ यू, दोज हु हैव नॉट सीन द मूवी, यू कैन वॉच दैट मूवी. व्हाट डज सेरेंडिपिटी मीन? अ स्ट्रिंग ऑफ फॉर्चुनेट एक्सीडेंट्स. मोस्ट ऑफ आवर लाइव्स is like that. We really don't know what is going to conspire in future, but when we look back, you can connect the events, you can connect the dots in the hindsight. I remember, after my computer engineering in NIT Suratkal, I wanted to, before entering the corporate sector, that was before the civil service, I wanted to write GATE and get into Indian Institute of Science. I got selected in the written exam, and I was called for interview, and I was rejected in the interview. At that time, I had felt bad. Hey, Indian Institute of Science, jana tha, reject ho gaya. But then when I look back at life now, so I feel ki, even though that would also have been a great career, I feel jo upar wala karta hai, whatever God does or destiny does, whoever you believe in, nature does, you achche ke liye hota hai. So the lesson is, what do you have to do? You have to remember to keep moving forward. Because at every point of time, you will, in your life, you will have options. It is always good to keep moving forward. Next. Yes. We will all be 80 one day. Yes, sir. Are. Yes or no? Now you are in cloud 9, doesn't mean that it's good to be, we will all be 80 one day. This is one principle that I have for myself. What is that? At 80, you have a cup of coffee in your armchair. What should you not have? Regret. Regret of not having tried what you wanted to do in life. Theek hai? This you should promise me. Don't worry about success and failure. Every successful person, when he stands before you, he would have failed in many other aspects of his life. If that will not be highlighted before you. Why? Because as a society, we embrace success. Yes, every one of us want to be successful. But in your heart and heart, try and do whatever you are passionate about, whatever you wanted to do. Next. Once you go out to the academy, the gana hai na, those were the best days of my life. So academy days are the best days of your life and best days of my life. Have no two doubts about it. The camaraderie that you develop here, Anandi, my batchmate, is here. She would vouch ki the among all the WhatsApp groups that you would have, even now our foundation course, our Masuri batch, camaraderie, is probably one of the best in amongst all the groups that we have. So, but when you go out into the real world, life will hit you many times. Know this. Why? Because that is the nature of your life, in your career, in whatever you are doing. But at those moments in your life, remember to stay focused and be positive. It's easier said than done. Kyun? Kyunki hamesha aap bahut sare motivational video dekhe honge, jaise some of you would have failed in an UPSC attempt. The moment that you fail, how you felt and how you actually, oh, famous dialogue, hai na? It does not matter how many times you fall back. What matters is how many times you get up. That is how life is. So learn to always get up and keep moving forward. Remember this. Next slide. Choice. UPSC has given a flight ticket because of which you have all entered through the airport, and this is the you are at that point of life in your career. Jo aeroplane mein take off point hota hai na, take off mein seat belts on and aap runway ki starting point pe hai. You are all at that point. How you go, how far you go in your life is your choice. There is a famous saying, it's easier to reach the top than to stay there. You've all got certain things in life. Now it is your turn. You have to choose whether you want to consider this as the summit in your life, or you want to consider that this is the platform wherein you will achieve new heights. This is the choice that you will make. Baki to jo hoga, the results are not in our hands. But I would urge you to start your journey from here on and achieve new heights. Next, destiny. I am a great believer in destiny for myself, because growing up, I never thought I will, during my primary and middle schools, I was not getting admitted to the best schools, because I always started in village. They used to say, "Arey, he started in village, he might not cope up with the standard of education." So I never thought I'll become IAS collector, honorary doctorate, all this Paralympic medalist, Arjuna Award. I felt destiny has been very kind to me. It has been to all of you also. But then, how do we keep moving forward once we have received certain amount of gratitude and kindness from destiny? Everything starts from your thoughts. Sare cheez to isi se shuru hota hai na. The following lines do motivate me all the time. They are not mine. They are not my original thoughts. You would have read it also. Follow your thoughts, for that will become your word. Follow your word, for that will become your action. Follow your action, for that will become your habit. Follow your habit, for that will become your character. Follow your character, for that will become your destiny. Follow your thoughts, that will become your destiny. With this, I think I would open the floor now for discussion. I hope we have some more time before you are all extremely hungry. And so now we'll let us ask few. हम जब संपूर्ण आनंद में होते थे ना, तालियां दो टाइप की बजती थी. एक तो कि बहुत हो गया, लंच या शाम को निकलना है, या उस टाइम पे कि जब सही में अच्छा लगा. सो आई एम अज्यूमिंग कि आपका दूसरी वाला है. सो यस, जब डायरेक्टर सर रहते हैं तो हम लोग भी थोड़ा हिचकते थे कि वी आर ऑल्सो रिलक्टेंट कि क्वेश्चन पूछे कि ना पूछे. बट हमारे बैच में भी कुछ लोग होते थे कि ओवरऑल यू नो एंथू एनर्जेटिक. So whoever is asking question, don't worry. This is an informal session with the permission of director, sir. So nobody, but you can, no question is foolish. So you can ask whatever you want. Always the first question is the hardest. Second question, third question aa jati hai. Yes, ma'am. Ek mic, agar cordless mic hai, to de dijiye, nahi to I can, yes, aa jaiye, sir.
Thank you so much for sharing your inspirational thoughts with all of us, sir. My question is to what you said about the international sporting arena, that all of the people who come over there are very passionate and very intelligent. I was wondering, in an administration context, and if you look at, say, a lot of DMs during the COVID time, do you think it's only handling pressure that helped you perhaps do a bit better, or is there also other things that apply to administration, maybe uniquely, and not to sports? Thank you.
COVID was such a challenge wherein nobody had imagined the scale. And we all learn about disaster management. You guys must be having the classes of Disaster Management Act. COVID actually tested administrative capabilities to the limit. What I have seen is, what stood out was, yes, administrative capabilities, yes, it definitely is required. Human emotions. You have, because when you're at the fulcrum of coordination, people would have high expectations from you because you are the head, if you are district magistrate at the district level. You need to be extremely empathetic and you know these are the resources that are available. When the demand is so high that sometimes you are stretched to the limit, how do you actually do out-of-box thinking and involve the stakeholders? Because the biggest, I would say, not only challenge, in administration, as leaders, we should realize that it is the team that delivers. It's not the individuals. Finally, individuals will go and take up the trophy or individuals will take the blame. But the secret there is to motivate all your team members to actually deliver. Small example, we had put the duties in COVID hospitals. My additional district collector rang me up and told, sir, jo officers who are posted near the COVID hospitals, they are reluctant to go even to the sanitized area inside the hospitals because they feel ki unko COVID na ho jaye. I told, theek hai. That's a genuine fear that they might be having. So let us do one thing. The next day, I decided ki me and all my senior team management will, after taking proper precautionary measures, wear PPE kits, everything, we went inside the COVID wards to talk to the patients to show to the rest of the team that a leader should lead from the front. So it's generally not the words, but the actions that motivate your team. So sports mein bhi aise hi hai. It's not the words, but your, agar main ye sare baat bina medal ke bolunga to khokhla lagta hai. It's empty vessels making noise. So the words will have the gravity only if it is backed by the action, whether in life or in sports. Anybody else?
Thank you so much, sir, for enlightening us with your inspirational journey.
There is no enlightening, only thought provoking.
Yes, sir. So one thing
that enlightening hota hai to hum log kehte the to thoda enlightening bahut senior ke liye.
Yes, sir. Yeah. So one thing that we learned is that failure is better than regret. And I want to ask one question related to your passion for sport. So how did you manage your passion for badminton with the workload that you have as a DM of a district? How did you manage both these things?
So you guys all are quite busy. You have your classes from 8 o'clock till the afternoon. Then after 4 o'clock, you have your sports session. In your busiest postings also, you can always take out time for the passion that you wish to do. What I used to do was, during the peak of COVID, it was extremely difficult, but then I used to keep my badminton kit in my collector's vehicle. And sometimes the work used to get over at 8 o'clock in the night, 10 o'clock in the night, 12 o'clock in the night. But from directly after the work, I used to go to the court, play for 1 hour, 2 hour, 2.5, 3 hours. Time is a created thing. The biggest challenge there is, if you pursue something that you enjoy, the process will not be painful to you. I heard from many of the OTs, after you go in the night, many of you watch Netflix and Amazon Prime, or YouTube, you will watch for 2 hours, 3 hours. If you love the content, Do you get stressed? No. So if you choose something that you love, then those 2 hours, 3 hours will not actually create stress in you. Similarly for that, you should love your job. Because if you don't love your job, you will be stressed out and you don't want to do anything after that. So if you love your job, you are energetic. And after that, if you love your passion, whatever, sports, music, whatever you wish to do. And let me tell you, because of the posts that we hold, we are answerable to general public and to all the stakeholders. And generally, there is a belief that if you pursue other passions, there is a misconception. But now that misconception is more or less gone, that they might feel ki, arre bhai, ye to wohi karta hai. No, you deliver and they know ki ye kaam ko to compromise nahi karenge. He will go to the badminton court only at 12 o'clock if the work midnight, if the work is there. So then the reputation is set. But the challenge there is to love what you do. If you love what you do, you will really enjoy it. It's like being with your life partner. If you love your life partner, then you will really enjoy the time that you spend with your life partner. So that is, so choose something in life that you love, whether it is work or passion.
Sir, first of all, thank you for being so much relatable. And this is not a question as such. This is a statement that I felt I should make. Sir, thing is, I felt so much, I could relate with you so much what you were saying about choices, about happiness, about pursuit of happiness as such. What I wanted to say was, I am not a person who typically believe in role models. But if I were ever to think of a role model, that would be a person like you, because I think you feel happy. You are happy about what you are doing.
Even though it is not a question, I'll tell you, I'll give you a short answer or a statement. You need not have role models in life, but what you should have is, in every person you meet, you should pick up the qualities that you adore in them. You might not find all good qualities in one person, but it's like you should be like a bouquet. One flower here, one flower here. So all good qualities from so many inspirational persons you meet in your life, then your life will be like a beautiful bouquet. That is how it should be. So next question.
Sir, thank you for the outstanding session. It was full of goosebumps.
Outstanding, abhi mat bolna, baad mein feedback aata hai na. I will see ki how many have given you outstanding and how many have given you. Ma'am, wo feedback to dete honge sabko. To result zarur bhejiyega. Kyunki then I will, because just like that, and a memo bhi bhejiyega. If there is any memo, then wo ye. So, yes.
So my question is about motivation, especially our inner motivation, that how to channelize that and how to bring out our inner energy to achieve things in life. That is my question. Thank you, sir.
See, the challenge is, when the going is good, it's very easy to be motivated. Hai ki nahi? Life mein sab achha chal raha hai, to aap automatically motivated rehta hai. The challenge is, how do you, once you stand, running is easy. But once you are fallen down, getting up is more difficult. But then, that is where, agar sessions like this, if you can keep this in your mind, ki that is where your inner motivation comes from. There is, and let me tell you this, there is no one best journey of life. There is no one best journey. You should choose what suits you. Life is a journey, not a destination. Halaki meri wife kehti hai ki life mein which one should you, what do you like? Whether life is a journey or a destination. Wo kehti hai, nahi, life mein company zyada important hai, journey mein kyunki wohi kaam aate hai. So, yes, have good company, be motivated, especially at those times when you are when things are not going very good for you. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Sir, thank you so much for enlightening us again.
Actually, I'll accept the enlightening word.
And it is an honor to see you in person after seeing you on television. So my question would be, and I'm sure most of us would relate with it, like when someone has achieved something, everyone just see the success story. No one really gets to know the struggle, the days when someone is suffering to get up from bed, to do basic things. I'm sure you would have also seen such days in life. My question is, how did you cope with such days when you didn't feel like, you know, going to work or practice badminton? On such days, how did you actually find the strength to get up and, you know, go on with life?
Bilkul, you have hit the nail on the head. What I have seen in life is, life will give you what you really, when you really want something very badly. You have all prepared for UPSC? You wanted to crack the UPSC very badly. किसी भी हालत में हम इसको क्रैक करना है तो वो जो जुनून होता है सो एसेंशियली दैट जुनून और द पैशन टू एक्चुअली स्टैंड जैसे फॉर मी इट वाज आई वांटेड टू स्टैंड ऑन द पोडियम इन टोक्यो टू सी द ट्राई कलर गो जब वेन एवर आई यूज टू फील लिटिल लो मुझे लगता था कि अगेन एट 80 आई शुड नॉट हैव द रिग्रेट मैं अपनी जान लगा दूंगा Success failure is not in our hands. As I said, वो जो आपने ब्राज़ील का मैंने दिखाया, if I had not that particular point, if it would not have happened, maybe I would not have gone to the Tokyo. But if you see in that video, I wanted that very badly. If you want something very badly in life, you will find ways to do it. तो आप अगर mountain है, तो आप tunnel खोदोगे, आप इधर जाओगे. आपको पार करना है अगर वो अंदर चाहत है तो देन यू विल फाइंड अ वे टू डू यस
गुड आफ्टरनून सर
अभी थोड़ा तालियों की ये कम हुई है तो पूरा कम हो जाती है तो विल एंड द सेशन
कांग्रेचुलेशंस ऑन योर सक्सेस सो माय क्वेश्चन टेकिंग ऑफ फ्रॉम द मेंशन ऑफ सक्सेस देयर इज हाउ डू यू हैंडल दैट सक्सेस एंड हाउ डू यू स्टे ग्राउंडेड बिकॉज I believe a lot of people here have achieved some amount of success to be here. And sometimes there's a chance that it can get into our heads. So what would you advise on how we need to stay grounded and how to stay focused on the reality of life?
Sir, this is extremely relevant and pertinent questions. Every day when I get up, when I pray to God, I thank him because in my life, as I said, I never thought I will come this far. And I say to myself that during our college days, we used to go in motorcycles, we used to enjoy life. But when we actually come further in life, we associate our identity and happiness to so many things. For one example, to the chairs or seats that we hold. So if our identity is not associated with the chairs that we hold, or the medals that I wear, or the success, whatever, tamga, the crown that you wear. As an individual, you should be disassociated from all that. Why? Because in heart, we should know that destiny has been kind to us. As I said, many deserving people who are probably more hardworking did not get as much success as me and you are. So my second slide was gratitude. Helps, it is also functionally good. Why? It will help you to achieve further. As a sports person, when I enter into my next championship, the score is what? 0-0. The other person who did not win the medal this time, he will try to defeat me. So sports, mein toh sports is a great leveler. So it will keep me grounded. But in administration, you will all go into the fields, you will all, when you go into the field, koi pani pilane ke liye aa raha hai, koi darwaza khol raha hai. So don't associate yourself with all this strings. When I was in Lucknow, I used to, when I shifted from DM Prayagraj, I still have my scooty and use. I drive my scooty to the badminton academy. Why? Because मुझे पता है कि अगर मैं उससे खुश हो सकता हूँ, if I can derive happiness by driving my scooty and with a kit, that nobody can take away from me. So. So last one or two questions and then I many hungry ye hoga to whenever you say
sir good afternoon sir
yes ma'am yes
so thank you for such an interesting session and many many congratulations to you. I have a little offbeat question. Is there a particular player in badminton who inspired you to take up the sport, and who is your favorite opponent currently?
मैम पहले फेवरेट अपोनेंट बताता हूँ, देन आई टेल यू हाउ आई टुक अप बैडमिंटन. फेवरेट अपोनेंट इज वर्ल्ड नंबर वन हु आई लॉस्ट द फाइनल्स. ये है क्योंकि अपोनेंट शुड ऑल्सो बी वर्दी ऑफ बीइंग एन अपोनेंट. बाकी जिनको आपने हराया है, यू डोंट, यू हैव ऑलरेडी डिफीटेड. सो यस, ही इज डेफिनेटली इज अ फ्रांस प्लेयर. सो हाउ डिड आई love the game? I used to play so many sports along with my studies since childhood, and badminton was one of them. But the days in Mussoorie in foundation course, I still remember M.M. Pandey sir, he is now settled, retired Sports Authority of India coach. He was a Sai coach at that time. Now Negi sir is there. So I used to think I play decently, and one day he saw me playing well. He told ki you seem to be playing good, so come, I'll make you play. So generally I used to go a little early so that I get the court. Now we have got so many courts. I think director sir and all predecessors have been extremely kind to you. So at that time one court was there, the second court was built later. So he told, okay, stand there, you hit the shuttlecock to me, I will give you everywhere. So I told her, kar lenge. He was at that time 56, 57 year old person. So then he started feeding me the shuttles, and after that, after it would have, it'd be around 5 minutes. So I was extremely tired. So he told, ki, bhai, you think you play well, but you don't play as well as what you rate yourself. So you want to improve, do this. Then the first, that was a sort of realization ki I need to improve a lot. So then I sort of, jaise kehte hai na, if you ask somebody, aap, how did you fall in love with somebody? It's very difficult to say. Like I fell in love with badminton in the academy. So it's very difficult to say why. But I did fall in love with badminton. And yes, after, during the probation, I fell in love with a girl who I married and who is my wife. So yes, both that love and this love has given me the happiness. Yes.
Sir, this is my second last question.
No, we can, till director sir says stop, hard stop, I can go on. Because see, coming here, talking to you, I feel the honor and I feel the energy, and I am more happy than you. I don't know how happy you are. I have given many talks, I have given corporate talks, many academies, but nothing feels like home. But thanks to director sir for the duniya ke bade bade company ko di hai ya jo bhi aur jagah di hai, but this is like, mujhe lagta hai ki main, I am standing at home, and this is a special feeling for me.
So which career will you suggest to your kid? Sports, civil services, or something else?
Acha, main batata hu iska answer dusre. This is a generally we say ki what do you choose? Civil service, badminton. I look at it in another way. मैं ये सोचता हूँ कि civil service, badminton, and then what? Which is the third one or the fourth one? Life should be like that. So I would, just like my father said, my family wanted me to be a doctor, and because I was born differently abled, my family wanted to take sort of revenge against the nature, isko orthopedic surgeon banana hai. So but I took the in our in after 12th I took the MBBS seat, and But I, in my heart, I wanted to be an engineer. And so my family was, and I know 70% or 80% are engineers, so you would like it. So mere papa ne bulaya, he told ki, I know you have taken the MBBS seat, but jo dilwale dulhaniya le jayenge, main kehte na ki, ja simran jile apni zindagi. Unhone kaha, ja jile apni zindagi, go and become an engineer. So, yes. So, what my father told me is, go and do what you love. That is why I played the song. Once upon a time, my father told me, we all will die, but we should live a life that we will all remember. That is what I'll tell my kids also.
Good afternoon, so, sir.
Good afternoon.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. Arre taliyan bajaiye, inke liye bajaiye. Ma'am, course coordinator can also veto because we are running little out of time. So, jab aap kahenge ki we will hard stop. Otherwise, I feel the, they are enjoying. We can overshoot by few minutes.
Thank you, sir, for such an inspiring session. And thank you to my batchmates also to give me a chance to finally ask a question.
Enlightening hua. Ye sab likhna final gopni feedback mein. Secret feedback jo dete.
Sir, actually, I have a personal story with you. I want to share this. And I also have a question. I have a personal anecdote. I was previously in Danik service, and I was, as you said, rightly said, we were posted at different hospitals, and I was posted at as nodal officer of Loknayak Hospital during COVID. Sir, आपको पता होगा, आप शायद मुझे नहीं जानते होंगे, but जो ऑक्सीजन के टैंकर्स आते थे कभी नोएडा फरीदाबाद से दिल्ली बॉर्डर्स पे, they used to be stopped. तो सर, there was an oxygen crisis at Loknayak one day, and me and my batchmate, we coordinated with your administration and you. And there was a smooth movement of the tanker. Sir, SHOs lagaye jaate the, if you remember, with the tanker.
Yes, yes, I do.
And because of that, about 2,000 to 3,000 lives that day was saved at Loknayak Hospital, sir.
Ye wo wala to nahi thali ki ho gaya wala.
And sir, it was during the night. I really want to thank you for your proactiveness. And sir, I wanted to ask one question. You said that please do what you love. But sir, what if we don't know what we love? How to identify?
Yes, right here.
Thank you so much.
देखिए, life में ना ज़िंदगी एक खोज है. We will have. It is. You might discover your love at the age of 20. You might discover your love at the age of 60. It does not matter. But what you should do is keep looking. Okay, don't stop searching for what you love in life. To hota kya hai, practically kya hai, if you really don't love, aap aadhe mein chhod dete ho, you will not pursue it. Jaise ma'am ne pucha, on days when you will feel that things are not going well, if you really don't love it, if you really don't want it badly, you would actually stop doing it. So aap उस दिन समझ लेना कि यू रियली डोंट लव इट, इट्स बेटर टू डू समथिंग एल्स. ऑन द डेज व्हेन थिंग्स आर नॉट गोइंग वेल, व्हेन यू रियली फील कि यार ये तो करना है, ये मान के चलना कि तुम्हें अपना प्यार मिल गया. सो आई थिंक, अच्छा एक और
सर, आई बिलीव दैट वी लर्न अ लॉट फ्रॉम आवर पीयर्स, नॉट ओनली अबाउट आवरसेल्व्स एंड आल्सो अबाउट होल लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. हाउ डू योर कॉम्पिटिटर्स inspire you, and what do you learn from them? How do you pick up, and more broadly, how does one develop a learning mindset among ourselves?
Yes, practically this is a very important question. Why? If we don't improve in sports, also in life also, you say main sports ka hi, if I give you an example, the competition next year will not be same as the previous year. Why? Because he will improve. So if we have to be relevant in competition, you will have to keep learning. So there is no two ways about it. Hota kya hai ki jab pani mein, when you are in the swimming pool, na, you will start swimming. So that is how in any competition, in administration, in civil service, in sports, you will, it's like in swimming pool, you will have to cross the line first.
Thank you so much, Yes.
So ma'am ne hard stop kar diya. So last two lines. So last two lines, because I know 2:30 ko dusra session bhi hai before that lunch. The two lines in Hindi that inspire me, again not my original, with that we will close. How many of you know Hindi? लगभग सभी को हिंदी मूवी देख देख के आ ही गया होगा. निगाहों में मंजिल थी, गिरे और गिर के संभलते रहे. इट सॉर्ट ऑफ एनकैप्सुलेट्स वॉट एवर आई हैव सेड, वॉट एवर लाइव्स दैट वी आर लीडिंग, मी एंड यू. निगाहों में मंजिल थी, गिरे और गिर के संभलते रहे. हवाओं ने कोशिश बहुत की, मगर चिराग आंधियों में भी जलते रहे. मे गॉड ब्लेस यू. May you get all that you want in life and enjoy your life. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. 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 Thank you.
I now invite on stage my fellow officer trainee, Anand Patel, for presenting the vote of thanks.
थैंक यू. नमस्ते. थैंक यू सुहास इतिराज सर. आई वुड लाइक टू बोरो सम लाइन्स फ्रॉम आउटसाइड. फेल्ट इंस्पायर्ड विथ अर्जुना अवॉर्डी और अर्जुना ऑफ दिस सेशन. सुहास इतिराज सर, यूअर जर्नी हैज़ बीन वेरी इंस्पिरेशनल एंड हैज़ बीन इंस्पायरिंग मेनी यूथ सर. इट हैज़ बीन प्रूवन दैट डिस्पाइट हैविंग डिफरेंट बैरियर्स, दे आर नॉट बैरियर्स. They are not barriers. We can achieve many things in our life which we inspire. You have given us many messages like courage. What courage we should have in our life. That is the main thing that you told, sir. And I would like to also thank our director, sir, Srinivas R. Katikitala, to be present here, sir, and make this session wonderful and gracing this wonderful session, sir. I would also like to thank our joint director, madam, Radhika Rastogi, madam, and Monika Dhami, madam, and faculty members. Thank you, sir, for being here. Thank you for being to the Labasna family. Yes, sir. Thank you.